in Ecclesiastes 1, and there is something called, we have a message to deliver, we have a communication to achieve. We have a gospel of life to share. And that is why we must talk. That's the first point. Talk, proclaim. It's not our making, it is an entrustment. And that is why the next is that words alone, it, my whole person must be a proclamation. My enthusiasm, my faith, my charity, my walking, my talking. If we do not have joy, and joy can only come, that is the joy of the Christian, can only come from a personal relationship, personal dialogue with God, ongoing, as I am nourished every day by the Word of God. It's only in that sense that I am now empowered to turn around and tell people, I have something to tell you. Then there is attraction. Bishop Joseph, from his academic background, so remarkable that in his, as he advanced in age, towards the twilight of his own ministry, he is now so possessed by that realization. You do not debate with the communists. You dialogue. You share. You listen. Is there something you can learn from them? Now you have something to share. In the Philippines, for a long, long time, we have the triumphalism of a gospel that gave us the wrong notion of superiority over others. This is not peculiar to us. That is, in the Middle Ages, the intolerance of the church for error. Oh, we glory by stating error is not right to exist. Do you see the echo of that now today in ISIS, in the Islamic State, in Iraq and Syria? You are a Christian, you have no right to exist. Either you change or we kill you. Either you become like us or we have all the reason and justice to exterminate. Once upon a time, we were saying the same thing, in effect. Thank God we have moved out of it, but not completely. We are still going around with the chip on our shoulders. I have the truth. You really have to ask, where is the truth, Father? In the book, where is the truth? The truth must be incarnated. That is the way of Christ to enter to dialogue with us. He became one like us. The principle of incarnation is what is needed in any dialogue. Can you put yourself in the shoes of your partner? You must go beyond exclusivism. You must now be welcoming. You must enter into partnership. You must identify with the one you're talking to. He's so precious to God. God is waiting with eternity for him. Can you do less in time? A culture of dialogue is actually a spirituality of love. Everything revolves, that's why dialogue is not a gimmick, it's not a temporary technique to assuage and to lull your opponents into pacified modality. No. Dialogue is of the essence of the gospel. It's a way of life. That's why it is a spirituality. And that's why the church, and we in particular, we must always be in dialogue. And today, as we are waiting for the next encyclical of Pope Francis on climate change. That is what Father Ed mentioned. He is simply not pushing dialogue. Do you know that he came over to dialogue with us? Those who survived in London. And he dialogued. He dialogued not so much with words, but his very presence, as whether in the Cathedral of Manila, approaching the elderly nuns and the elderly priests, and later on going into the tahanan for the homeless kids nearby. He spoke with the very sacramentality of his person. That's why he came. And the people without theology felt it. They were satisfied to be 5 kilometers to the Pope, 2 kilometers to the Pope. They could not touch him at all. He was there. He was a message. He was there for them. That's dialogue. People later asked me, Monsignor, you touch him. May I touch you, man? May I kiss you, man? You know, Moses. But, you know, that is our religiosity, and that is true. That's why Christ must be found. Before we can find him in others, we must make sure he can be found in us. That's our duty, and that's what people are looking for. In dialogue, we have something so precious to share, we cannot stand still. We have something so wonderful to proclaim. We are beaming with joy. We are overflowing with love. We can only repeat with Christ. Again and again he said, that you may be where I am, and where is he? In the embrace of the Father. But you must be there. We must be there in the embrace of God. Oh, what a sweet duty. What a mission, heavenly, beyond our nature. We who are so temporary are now given the destiny of eternity. We who are perishable are to become imperishable. We who are mortal are to become immortal. Because God has so treasured our human nature, He is sharing with us His divinity. That is what this is all about. And that is why, whatever it takes, we will dialogue, we will speak about it, we will share it, we will personify it. Amen. Salamat po sa inyo.